High volume.
So this is another skincare update. You guys have seen my old pictures, and so I'm just gonna be taking you through every new product I've been using, like just step by step, so you know exactly what I'm doing to help my skin and prevent that terrible acne from coming back. Because seriously, that was only a few months ago, so it's like I'm not out of the woods yet. So after washing my face, there is one product that I've been using that I've wanted to use in the past, and I never got around to doing it. Like, I've heard people rave about rose oil, like completely rave about it. The first time I heard about it, it was a few years ago. I would say, maybe more than a few, like 5 or 6. it was a while ago. Someone was talking about how it's just awesome for like fading like acne scars or like scars from boils or pocks, like really, really quickly. And then someone else had said something about using it as an antidepressant, like to boost your mood and just make you feel better. So fast forward to the present, 2016, I finally got my hands on some from like a reputable brand, and it is legit. It's the real stuff. So mine comes in a little glass dropper, and it's rose oil, antioxidant, face, body, hair, Bulgarian rose oil, and it has jojoba oil and rose hip oil. This blend is so calming. Like the scent, if you're into oils, I think this is definitely one you need to have. It's even great for like soothing fevers and different things like that. So it's not just a beauty product, which is what I thought it was at first. I'm using this actually as an astringent. So you know how after you wash your face, you're supposed to use a toner. So I chose rose oil because not only did I not want a toner that was going to leave my face like feeling tight, you know, that tight, dry feeling you get after some. Yeah, I wanted it to still feel moisturized, but still like super, super soft. And then once I figured out just how quickly and just well it is for like balancing your skin tone and getting rid of marks, that's when I really like started making it like a part of my everyday routine. I will also mention that while I use a few drops of this on a cotton ball every night on my face, I also use it in my hair as well. Basically because it's like an antifungal, antiviral, antiseptic oil. It has a lot of the same properties that like a tea tree oil has, and so if you've ever used like a tea tree oil on your scalp, you know just that amazing feeling, that like clean feeling. You know, there are some products that just sit on top of your hair, not really doing much to moisturize. If you guys have things like dandruff or like really, really itchy scalp, products that are antiviral, antiseptic, those are really what you want to knock out those, I'm gonna say infection sounds really serious, but if you've ever had dandruff or just any type of scalp issue, I mean, it is kind of like that, and you just need to like kick it out. Usually you have to use like heavy medicated shampoos and conditioners and things like that. I would recommend rose oil and tea tree oil for really nixing any scalp problems that you might be having. So let me know if you guys have any questions, just leave them down in the comment section below. I just made some chicken salad and I need a sandwich. I got this little Hawaiian roll bun things. Like, did you notice? Like, they started making them in buns and like even hot dog buns, and they're delicious. But yeah, I'm gonna go make one of those. I'll see you guys later.